Hi, welcome to At Home with Corning. My name is Steve Letke, and I want to tell you a little bit about some of our powering options that we have at Corning. Many applications that we design into our networks that are considered fiber deep actually require some sort of means to power these devices and therefore power the applications that are connected to their network. Such things such as remote cameras, security cameras, the access points that are out there in the network, small cells, could be voice over IP phones, etc. Things that require PoE. So we have a couple different parts of our solution that we incorporate into probably 90% of our fiber deep designs. One of those things would be a power supply. It is utilized for many of our fiber deep solutions, including distributed antenna system solutions or small cell solutions, as well as our SD-LAN fully managed solution, as well as our touchless network solutions. So what I'd like to show is a few things online. I'm going to share my screen just a sec, put this into share mode, and I'm going to talk about our power supply unit. And the power supply unit that we have is pretty straightforward, actually. It's a one rack unit type of power supply chassis. It comes with 12 ports right on the front. Each port is 100 watts, 57 volts DC out. You have the capability of adding hot swappable power supply modules that go into the back of the chassis. And you can always add those as needed based on the total amount of devices being powered. It's a class 2 type of installation. You do not require a licensed electrician to install this device, so it can be installed by a low voltage technician. They're straightforward. You just stack them up based on the number of devices that are required. You can actually split the ports depending on the PoE budget as well. We do that in plenty of designs where 100 watt port could actually support up to two endpoint devices. So it all depends on the PoE requirements, total budget, and distance away from the endpoint. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a sec. Here it is. So if you look at some of these examples of what the PoE budget on the screen would be, you're dealing with 30 watts, 60 watts, or even 75 watts. This is total PoE budget for the device. So you may have multiple devices connected at the edge, and that's why we're solving for these different scenarios here. Many devices that are out there are still pulling just PoE, but we do know that there's certain devices that are pulling for PoE plus up to 30 watts. And you may have multiple devices on one endpoint that require these higher PoE types of draws. So it's important to understand the max distance and look at the total distance that you need to require, as well as the gauge. So for example, if I pick 60 watts here as an example as the PoE budget, and I look at the gauge on the left, you can get an idea what your max distance might be based on that gauge. You can look here, if I see 20 gauge at 60 watts, I can go up to 295 feet. But if I switch that gauge to 12 gauge, I can go up to 1800 feet there. That's a lot. So most of our solutions fall, on the lower end, especially for in building, but there are long reach solutions that are out there for security camera systems going around the perimeter of a property that hit that 1,000 foot mark very commonly. So I wanted to make sure you understood that. And let's talk a little bit about our composite cable. So as far as our composite cable solutions that we offer, we actually have a lot of varieties. And I got a couple here as samples. This is a 2-fiber, 2-copper conductor. This is a plenum rated tight buffered type of cable. We use this mainly indoors. Very, very useful. It's a high runner for us. We keep this made all the time. In the plenum space, we also can go up in gauge. So the minimum amount of fibers that you can get in the convergence scenario is a 1-fiber, 2-copper. That's the smallest type of scenario that you can have. And then as far as fiber to copper ratio, you can go 24 fibers and up to 12 copper conductors. Now the gauge can change. We go anywhere from 20 gauge to 12 gauge in the conductor sizes. So there's a huge matrix and configuration. You can actually do armored version, plenum rated. There's an example of that showing a 12 fiber. This is loose tube. here, and then there's six copper conductors there. This one is got, looks like 16 gauge on it. And then here's an indoor-outdoor version right there. So the indoor-outdoor version we have, again, loose tube. This also is a 12 fiber and a six conductor scenario. This one is, looks like 14 gauge. So a lot of options there. It can also be an armored as well for that indoor-outdoor version. It's important to understand that and doing your design to know how many conductors you require. The main benefit of this is that because you can do higher counts of fiber and copper, that means you can add different devices and multiple devices at the edge to expand the scalability of things. And that reduces the amount of cables that are pulled out to those endpoints. You can go long distances without having to worry about the 300-foot rule. You don't have to worry about adding remote power, or at least I'm saying local power at the location that requires that power. So you don't have to add 120 volt at that endpoint. You can just go ahead and pull the cable to that point, and there you go, you get your power. Another nice thing about this is that these are rated for 300 volts. So if you have a scenario that you want to utilize a digital electricity solution, you can increase that power as well and handle up to 1,000 watts, for example, at the edge. So a lot of flexibility with this solution. It saves you space, it saves you labor by being able to design a fiber deep network. And if you're looking for more information, please contact your local solutions engineer or click on the link below for more information. Thanks a lot and have a great day.